All right. I'll continue on the story of Thirunyana Sambandar. In the 63 Leelas of Shiva, please understand, 64 Leelas are described, but one Leela is his presence, no action. That is why I am saying 63 Leelas. 63 are only actions. The word Leela can be attributed only to action, not for presence. So in that 64, one is presence, no action. 63 are action. In that 63, you will be surprised. The Leela done by Thirunyana Sambandar, winning the Jain preachers through the fire test and water test, is also added. Please understand. This means Jnana Sambandar was directly respected and accepted as Shiva's incarnation. That is the reason, even though this Leela is done by Thirunyana Sambandar, it is added in the Leelas of Shiva. Please understand, all other Leelas, Shiva directly comes down and executes the Leela. Shiva assumes the human body and does the actions. But this one, winning the Jain monks and establishing the Saiva tradition by the water test and fire test, it is done by Thirunyana Sambandar, but it is added in that 64 Leelas. Means even at that time, when he was living in the body, he was recognized, accepted, worshipped as directly Shiva's incarnation. Leelas done by Thirunavukkarasar was never considered as Shiva Leelas. It is done by Thirunavukkarasar through the grace of Shiva. Leelas done by Sundarar was never recorded as Shiva Leelas. It is Leelas done by Sundarar through Shiva. But Leelas of Thirunyana Sambandar directly recorded as Shiva Leela. So Jnana Sambandar was widely accepted, recognized, revered, worshipped, incarnation of Shiva himself, Mahadeva himself. No other branch of Shaivism, no other tradition in the Vedic religion talks about Shiva's Leelas. Shiva was always considered to be the frozen Himalaya, frozen Kailash. Only Krishna was considered as flowing Yamuna, doing all Leelas, entering into the barren land, making it fertile, flowing through the valleys and hills, reaching the ocean. Leela means the pure consciousness entering into the matter, nature, maya, prakriti, and playing as it wants. It's like you have already completed PhD, but you casually enter the first standards class and you just do any mathematics given in the first standard book and any syllabus given in the first standard book. You read everything, you master everything, you memorize everything, you show all your powers to the first standard students. What will that poor fellows do? Leela is like that. The ultimate enters into the lowest possible existence and plays with all the powers. So naturally, what will all the first class students do? They will all clap. Oh, see this student, see this student. He knows everything written in our book. Hey, this fellow only can write like this many books. Oh, he will not know whatever is written in the book. Leela is the extraordinary consciousness landing in the lowest possible existence and playing. It was always attributed to Vishnu. The Leela aspect was never attributed to Shiva in Hindu tradition. It was always attributed to Vishnu. Only Vishnu takes 10 avatars, 10 incarnations, comes as Krishna, comes as Rama, comes as Narasimha, does all divine plays, leelas, never ever leela was attributed to Shiva. Never ever the Shiva's leelas were absorbed, experienced, described other than the tradition of Madurayadinam, the Veda Neri. Only in the tradition of Madurayadinam, such beautiful visual, detailed, factual, historical presentations of Shiva Leela is described. Shiva, assuming the body of lower frequencies, like human body, pig body, so many lower frequency bodies he assumes and expresses the super consciousness and plays with these powers. I tell you, just reading that 64 leelas, I wanted all the devotees and disciples all over the world to watch the Thiruvalaiyaadal movie once more. Only 4 leelas are described in that movie. I am not saying whatever is shown in the movie exactly factual. It is not completely factual. The Dharmi is shown like a comedian in the movie, but he is really a great devotee. He is not a comedian. He is a highly devoted, dedicated disciple of Mahadeva, Shiva. He only wanted little bit of money to perform his religious rite. Please understand, in those days, only if you are married, you will be allowed to touch the temple deity and worship. You can't worship the temple deity if you are not married. Even now, in Chidambaram, the Dikshidas, if they have to touch the main deity and worship, they need to receive an initiation which will be given only after marriage. So before marriage, you will not be allowed to touch the main deity and worship. That is why among the Dikshidars, even now the child marriage is common. By the age of 12, 13, even men get married. Because if you don't get married, you can't receive that initiation and do the puja directly. So this Dharmi, he was supposed to be initiated. He need to start the puja directly. Before that, he has to get married. So for that marriage, he did not have money. That is why he was asking Shiva to support him with a little bit of money. Only then the whole leela started. Anyhow, even if there are one or two factual errors, overall the movie presents a beautiful view of Shiva's leelas. When I was reading the 64 leelas, continuously I am reading, whenever I am finding time, among all these leelas which I am doing, I have little time to read those Shiva leelas. When I read those leelas, oh God, I really feel even the Saraswati which is in my tongue cannot describe the grace of his leela. I really feel no saliva. The mouth with saliva cannot describe his pure grace. I can only try to give some few incidents. Sundareshwara, please understand, I am throwing a bomb. Sundareshwara is not Shiva. He is not Shiva as you understand. Sitting in the Himalayas, frozen in the ice, in Samadhi. No. He is Shiva and Krishna put together. Playing Leelas so casually, so beautifully. PhD student sitting in his room is not a great thing. First standard students just sitting and struggling their own way to learn the mathematics and English is not a great thing. PhD student coming to the first standard students and playing with them, showing his power and saying, tomorrow you can also do PhD, is Leela. That is Leela. Inspiring those first standard students to become PhDs is Leela. Sundareshwara is such a powerful being, playing and expressing Leelas. Still I am not able to think which Leela to tell first, which one to leave. ஐயோ ஒன்னா ரெண்டா 64 ஆச்சே 64 ஆச்சே எதை சொல்லுவே எதை விடுவேன். ஒன்னு வந்தா இன்னொன்னு தொண்டையில விக்குதே, இன்னொன்னு வந்தா தொண்டையில இன்னொன்னு சிக்குதே. வாட் வில் ஐ டெல், 1 or 2 64? இஃப் ஒன் கம்ஸ் டு த த்ரோட், அதர் ஒன் கம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஸ்டாப்ஸ் அண்ட் தட் வாண்ட்ஸ் டு கம் அவுட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட். பட் ஒன் திங் ஐ கேன் பி ஷூர், ஹி இஸ் ஸ்டில் அவைலபிள் continuously. Just like when Dharmi went and cried in the temple, Chokka, he appeared and answered. Even now, if you go and cry in the temple, he is there, and I promise you, he assumes human body and relates with you, answers you, responds to you, raises you. I am not lying, and there is no need for me to lie. I am telling you exactly as he is, as she is. He stays in a frequency where he can immediately assume human body. When Tirunyana Sambandar came in the human body and did all these divine leelas, leelas of establishing this great religious tradition, this great spiritual tradition, every step, every inch, every word he uttered is leela. When I remember, I am lost into this whole.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam. Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam, nityanandaya swagatam, nityamukta.